Hey guys, welcome back. So as you can see, we are in a small little Cessna 172. But the airport at which we are is between mountains. So as you can see, these mountains are really huge. And I have no idea how planes fly here in real life. But one more important factor of this airport is that the runway is really short. And when I say short, I mean short. So here is our Cessna 172 and this is the runway. So now that you have got an idea of how short this runway is, let's try to take off our little Cessna 172 out of here. Alright, so full power and let's go. I'm not sure whether this is gonna work or not because the end of runway is already here and we are at around 45 knots only. We need 60 knots to rotate. Come on, please lift off. Oh my god. Oh. Okay, we are. Oh. Damn, this was absolutely crazy. I did not expect this. Even a Cessna 172 was not able to take off. Now what is gonna work then? Alright, so now we are gonna do a static takeoff. So right now we are pushing back a little bit so that we can use every inch of the runway because that is important now. So engines are running at 100% right now and let's release the parking brake. Rotate. Come on, lift off you boy. God damn it. Okay, so right now we are in a Saab 340. And I think this could work because Saab 340 has two engines. Okay, so let's release the parking brakes and there we go. Come on, rotate. This is working, guys. We took off from this airport. Wow! Saab 340, congratulations, you did it. So, now it's time to move on with little bigger planes and little stupid. So now we are in Embraer 190 and this is a lot bigger than the Saab 340. Just to give you an example how much big, Saab 340 can just carry 36 passengers. Well, this can carry 70 passengers. So it's almost double the size. So again we are doing a static takeoff and I'm not sure whether this is gonna work or not. Let's go Embraer 190. You can do this. Maintaining the center line is itself a big problem. Oh my god, this is not gonna work. Well, you know what? Let's try to land this plane because landing is also a very big challenge at this airport. As you can see, we are almost about to crash on this mountain and our runway is right there, as you can see. Let's go and try to land. Okay, so we are almost about to touch down. Just a small nosedive. And there we go. Perfect landing, guys. Congratulations. So buttery landing. Wow. So let's go a little bit smaller. Saab 340 could work, I guess. Alright guys, so this is a very stabilized approach. 10x10 perfect approach. Ouch! Damn, this was so hard. Actually, the main problem of this airport is not the short runway. The main problem is the mountains between the approach, which really make the approach horrible. So now, hopefully there is only one plane which can land here and that is obviously Cessna 172. Because this plane has only one engine, which is not very powerful, and this plane can fly at very slow speeds, 60 knots, which is really damn slow. So this can work. Let's try it out. So as I told, this is kind of working. We are at very slow speed and we are about to land. Slam! Damn! Alright guys, so this was a hard landing. but we stopped before the runway number started. Just look at this. 09, lol. So only Cessna 172 can land here, and obviously it can take off in real life. I don't know why it was not working here. So yeah, that was the video, and don't forget to subscribe for more. I hope you enjoyed. Goodbye.